Hello and welcome back to the Healthcare Uncomplicated YouTube channel. Before I proceed, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, check all the previous content there and share with your communities in healthcare and life sciences. And without further ado, let me introduce you to David Klein. He's the CEO at Click Therapeutics. David, how are you?
I'm pretty good. Nice to meet you here. And thanks for having me on your show.
Brilliant. Thanks for being here and accepting the invite. And today we are here to discuss a very exciting topic, digital therapeutics and the new standard of care. And the first question that I have for you, David, is can you describe digital therapeutics and its potential in healthcare and life sciences?
Sure. So digital therapeutics, what we mean by that term, are really just, you know, it's actually pretty simple, software that treats disease. So we're creating, in our case, mobile applications, so phone applications in general, that actually are proven to treat certain diseases. So that's what we mean by digital therapeutics. And, you know, to that end, it's probably got more potential or, you know, the same or more potential than any other modality we've seen emerge in medicine. And that's from, you know, biologics to cell therapies to gene therapies. I would look at this category as potentially as big, if not bigger, than categories of medicine that have come earlier. And essentially, the potential and the promise is that these programs not only can physicians offer more effective and often even safer care to patients, but these programs ultimately could really help bridge current gaps in care and can be broadly accessible to really anyone in the world with a smartphone. So if you can imagine from the most rural areas to inner cities to developing countries, if someone could potentially get their medicine directly on a phone, that can impact the entire planet. So it's a very exciting area of medicine that's, you know, starting to come up and becoming more and more mainstream. And we believe that the potential of it is really to revolutionize the entire world of medicine.
Brilliant. Thank you, David, for that overview and also the exciting things that you describe. And of course, this is a really, really serious thing happening. I like what you said about the simplicity and also the accessibility, which there are very important points. Moving on, how digital therapeutics contributing to the evolution of standard of care practices in healthcare?
Sure. So, as we see, we really feel that the clinical rigor is key to it, to advancing the whole space. So we hold our digital therapeutics to the same type of rigor that you'd see coming out of traditional pharmacotherapies. And the goal there is really to prove that these programs, that these apps, which are actually technically classified as medical devices, should be incorporated into standard of care. I think we're still in the, you know, call it first inning, maybe in the bottom of the first inning at best of this space, but you will start to see these programs in many aspects really revolutionize standard of care. So if you can envision a patient having a consulting a doctor via telemedicine or going to a physician's office, in the past, that physician often doesn't have opportunities that are really consistent with the standard of care guidelines. Or, you know, for example, look at a space like insomnia. The clinical practice guidelines in that space really call for cognitive behavioral therapy for insomnia, so psychotherapy, to be the first line of treatment, right? And if that doesn't work, then, you know, patients could potentially be put on different medications and so on and so forth. That's a terrific example of once you're going to have regulatory cleared and proven effective software applications that a physician could recommend or prescribe, that could really revolutionize standard of care, not necessarily in the sense of standard of care the way it's being practiced now, but the way that the guidelines are actually calling for standard of care to be incorporated, which is psychotherapy first for many different diseases that patients simply don't have access. And you know, a lot of who has access to a sleep psychologist, for example. So often standard of care, the way that the guidelines are calling it for to be practiced, that area is being skipped and patients are going right onto medications. But even in instances where patients, where standard of care does call for first line treatments of pharmacotherapy, many of those guidelines incorporate behavior change into those guidelines. So you might have, let's say, high blood pressure, and a physician might prescribe a blood pressure lowering medication and say, oh, well, we'd like you to have only, you know, 50 grams of carbs a week, and, you know, so on and so forth. But if you can envision a software application being prescribed in conjunction with that medication, that can be a much more effective and potentially safer intervention that's better for the patient, it's better for the provider, it's better for the insurance company. If someone is really able to, you know, not just go on a medication, really to change their behavior in a lasting way, that person could potentially someday come off that medication or be on a lower dosage. So this is an area that, you know, doesn't just necessarily need to apply to mental health, but could apply to really almost every area of medicine.
Brilliant. Thank you, David. And certainly I've seen some schemes in Europe, what you described about ML mobile applications being prescribed now, being regulated, assessed, and also put up, is a completely new approach instead of kind of giving just medication, which is the standard, to actually offer an alternative and offer a mobile solution, a digital solution, which is fantastic to see. Moving on, what are the main benefits compared to traditional approaches?
Sure. So, you know, some of the main benefits, and I think what you're seeing now is really a new category even of prescription digital therapeutics. Click and other companies have moved beyond just simply translating CBT into a digital format into really an approach of delivering sophisticated multimodal treatments that are really designed not only to drive changes in behavior, but also to modulate neurological pathways for really sustainable, clinically meaningful change. And these benefits can go well beyond what you've seen in traditional healthcare approaches, even from what you've seen when folks are able to get psychotherapy in addition to drugs. We've now discovered and are developing ways to actually modulate neurological pathways, right? So in, you know, similar ways that some drugs have in the past, but using only a digital format. So what you've seen really are this start to be embraced, you know, not just by companies and using different modalities in the space, but even regulatory agencies, FDA, for example, just recently announced new draft guidance that really allows for software as medical devices that prove or that demonstrate clinically meaningful benefit when used in conjunction with drugs, to actually, that benefit can now be incorporated into the actual drug label. So if you look at you know, the magnitude of potential change that this can have over traditional, let's say, pharmacotherapies or traditional treatments, there's now a pathway to combine software and a drug and actually incorporate that into the treatment label. And patients are now, or will very soon be afforded much more, I would argue, safer and effective treatments that can be prescribed by their physicians. So I think that you're going to start to see really the entire world of medicine make a shift. I think you'll see a significant shift from pharmaceutical companies who in the coming years, the most successful drugs may be the most successful treatments that have the best software and the best drugs together, right? As opposed to simply just the best drugs. So very exciting developments in this space, not only for companies like Click that are really on the forefront of discovering and developing these new software interventions, but for the whole world of medicine that's really on the cusp of having safer and more effective ways to treat patients for serious diseases.
Thank you, David. Certainly very exciting days ahead. And the next and last question ties in very, very nicely with this, is how can digital therapeutics enhance patient outcomes and overall healthcare efficiency?
Yeah, so that's a great question too. And we can use that example. You're right, it ties right into that. So let's envision a drug may be good at, let's say, reducing itch and scratch behavior, but not terrific. Or a drug that does that, but doesn't necessarily improve quality of life. Imagine if that treatment was more effective. It also benefited things like quality of life and pain and fatigue. You would in the near future be able to prescribe something that is quite simply a more effective treatment that is better for the overall efficiency of the healthcare system, because there's now data showing that it's more effective. It enables potential for value-based contracting, so contracting around outcomes as opposed to just paying for the service, which would lead in our view, and I think it's been well published on in many cases, in better outcomes overall. So you're looking at a modality that not only could potentially, especially when combined with pharmacotherapies, result in better treatments for the patients overall, but could drive tremendous efficiencies throughout the whole healthcare market. You could have these programs that combined with certain molecules could be safer, more effective, and cheaper way to treat patients. And really everyone wins in that situation. The payers win, the providers win, the manufacturers win. So it's one of those unique paradigm shifts in medicine that really aren't taking from any of these buckets, but really just ensuring that the whole system in totality can become even more efficient.
Brilliant. David, that's actually very powerful, that combination of adding value to each other, to other stakeholders, instead of competing or taking money from somewhere else, really bringing all together. So a truly meaningful and powerful description there, what is coming around the digital therapeutics. Fantastic conversation. We could talk for a long, long time. We come to the end of the interview, David. I want to thank you for your time, these brilliant insights. I have one last little item related to the channel that I want to ask you, is how can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
Yeah, well, that's a terrific question and, loaded to some degree. I would say that empowering patients to really, help manage their treatments and help change their own behaviors really does reduce the complexity for many of these treatments, and frankly, help to understand their own behaviors, right? If a patient can understand, well, what's going on in my body and what am I doing that results in higher blood pressure, or what's going on in my brain that could contribute to this serious mental illness. That type of empowerment can really reduce significantly the complexity to so many of these diseases, and you know, create from what now many patients could view as this black box. Well, I'm sick and I have no idea why, to be really empowered, not only to understand the disease, to understand the mechanisms of that disease, but in a very simple and user-friendly way to start to take control and to really make changes that ultimately result not only in the improvement and or cure of some of those diseases, but in demystifying and uncomplicating so many of these different diseases and disorders.
Brilliant. Fantastic. David, we're going to leave it there because that was so, so good. I want to thank you again for your time, for your availability, and for being in here with us today. And of course, I want to wish you all the best and congratulate you on your work with the Click Therapeutics. And I'm sure that you're creating impact and you got big things to come. That's right, isn't it?
Yeah, hopefully. We're, you know, certainly trying our hardest, but we believe that we're, you know, that we're leading in this new space that is really on the cusp of entering into mainstream medicine, into standard of care, and revolutionizing the way that so many diseases are treated for the better. So thank you for your kind words, and hope to see you again. Happy to be on your show anytime.
Thank you so much, David. I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, acknowledge our channel partners, and I'm going to post also in the body of the video David's details in here, the social media around Click Therapeutics and David's LinkedIn. Ask them questions about their revolution and their approach, and I wish you all a very good time, and I'll see you next week.